Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am going to be setting up my main planner for 2019. In my planner lineup video, I had this Socialite planner to be my main planner, and then this one, I can't remember the name of it, but it's the mom one, not obviously the super mom one, but all the, you know, things in here are very mom-esque. But anyhow, this one was going to be like my fly lady cleaning thing. I've decided to combine them too because I don't even remember how many were on my planner lineup, but it was like 9 or something like that. So I'm going to combine the two. As much as I love this cover, I really, really do love this color or cover. I'm going to make this one my main cover. So I guess I can do that whole like transformer planner thing that I don't know everybody's doing. That was it, Whimsy Lindsay Plans, I think, is the originator of it, which was super brilliant of her. The only thing I don't like about that is how like the cover kind of sticks out a little bit in the middle part, and I think it would drive me nuts. So I've decided not to do that and just Frankenplan old school way. But anyhow, so I've already taken 6 months out of this planner so I could add other stuff to it. So the first part, I'd left, you know, obviously the 6 months in here. So what I'm going to do is at the end of this section, I'm just going to do 1 month at a time of this one, of the mom one for my fly lady cleaning type thing. So I am going to keep this in here, or in the, you know, this section, because I'm tracking my feminine stuff on that yearly. not that you need to see when my period was, but just to kind of watch my cycle, because my cycle is crazy funky. And if you watched my planner lineup video, I mentioned my ridiculous weight. Currently like 89 pounds now. It was 88. I gained a pound, so that was awesome. But yeah, so my cycle is kind of funky because I have like no fat storage in my body. But anyhow, so too much information, I'm sure. Anyhow, so this is my monthly, for this. I'm going to keep that in there and pull this out. Oops. And stick that in here. Now, I did mention in my video, my lineup video, that what I was going to try and do, because I'm terrible at journaling or whatever, was to use this for journaling purposes and just one little tidbit of, you know, event for the day or anything like that. And I've actually done pretty well. This was the only day, the 15th, I forgot. And then, like, by the time I remembered, it was the 17th, and I couldn't remember what even happened on the 15th. So that would be part of the reason I really, really need to do that. Because journaling, I'm never going to. Like, I tried last year to journal in a mini because I thought maybe the small spaces would be small enough for me to not feel intimidated by it. But I was still apparently intimidated by it, and I did it for a couple days and then I didn't do it at all. But so this is how I am using this for my fly lady. I've got, like, I don't know if you follow the fly lady thing. Well, I'm going to zoom you in a little bit just so you can like see what I've written in some of these sections, because it's, I'm sure, too tiny. Okay, so Fly Lady on Sunday night, I think, is when she publishes like her missions for the week. So you go onto little, on her website, and it's a very busy website. So that, it's very, you know, that was hard for me to get past because I don't like busy websites. They drive me nuts, like ads and things like that. They kind of make my brain hurt. But I push through because I really think that the Fly Lady system is something that will be beneficial for me. So anyhow, she posts her little daily missions, and then there's also stuff you're supposed to do, like, you know, your zone cleaning for 15 minutes, and then you have like your weekly home blessing, which is technically supposed to be all done in one day. Physically, with MS, I just can't. I don't have the physical energy to do everything one day, so I have it split out throughout the week. So this is what I'm using, you know, to do that. So I write the missions down at the beginning of that, and I broke it down into sections because it just looks more appealing to me. Then I have my zone that I'm going to be working on, and what in that zone I'm going to do. Then I have like the purse clean out, because that's one of her little daily things. Then I have some of the stuff that's supposed to be for that home blessing hour that you're supposed to do once a week, but like I said, I can't do. So anyhow, I'm gonna zoom you back out because this is like really big in frame. But anyhow, that's just how I set up the weeks for the whole Fly Lady thing. Then I'm gonna add some more sections in here. I've got the little Socialite dashboard thing, so I'm gonna use those to separate things out in a second. So anyhow, within this little Fly Lady section, I guess before the month, I have my morning routine typed out. My I have a different one for like Monday through Friday versus Saturday through Sunday. I may or may not leave that. Then I have my weekly tasks. So this is kind of that whole weekly home blessing thing. So I have like all the weekly tasks on here. It's just one-sided. And then I'm breaking down my zones to do like for like everything that needs to be done in that zone. If you know, specifically for my house. So I mean, like, broken down to the extreme, because like I said, with MS energy wise, I, you know, there's days where I have a little bit more energy than others, and there's some days where like walking from my bedroom to the kitchen, I am wiped out, like I'm exhausted, which is insane. But so I have it broken down. So what I'm gonna do is eventually I'm gonna laminate these, like not these specific ones. These are like my first try at it, so I'll probably make notes on it, things like that, things that need to be changed, and then I'm gonna laminate it, and then as I do those things, I'm gonna mark them off so that the next month when I'm back in that specific zone, I'll know what I already did, and I'll move on to something else, and do that. So I have a few of the zones already done. I think zone two, which is the kitchen, I do the dining room with that too. She's got that in a different zone, but it just makes more sense to have it with the kitchen with me, because my kitchen basically runs into my quote unquote dining room. I'd say dining area, it's not a dining room. My house is too small for a dining room. But anyhow, so I have like, oh, and this is like the stuff that needs to be done periodically. Like, so like deep clean of like, you know, the kitchen grout and the inside of the fridge and the inside of the dishwasher, things like that, things that I don't need to do super often, but should have, you know, should be doing it somewhat consistently. So, and then I have like my zone three and zone four. So I still need to do zone one and zone five. But I'm doing it little by little as I'm in that zone. That way I know what needs to be done. So anyhow, like I said, eventually those will be, laminated, but until I have a final copy of it, I guess, or I don't want to waste my lamination sheets because I just bought them. So anyhow, so that's that. The next part I'm going to put back here, after the monthly for the Fly Lady stuff. Like, I'm kind of using this back section as like my personal stuff, I guess. So I made some, habit trackers. I don't like the little grid ones where you shade in. I like to see the month. So I made these. I've already started some of them. So I just, you know, I didn't date it because I didn't know how many I would need for the month or whatever. So I just, you know, wrote in my dates, and these are all January. So I just put things that I want to do consistently. And things will change, like the habits that I'm going to track change. I want to, until I do something and get green on at least 60 days worth of, you know, that habit, I'm going to keep it on there. And once I hit 60 days, then it, to me, has become an actual habit and not something that I'm reminding myself to do because it's on my little habit tracker. Because apparently, I think, like, it's been going around for a long time that 21 days is, you know, how long it takes to form a habit. Well, technically, it's not. I guess some studies came out and now it's like the average is 66. Some people are less, some people are more. So I'm going to go with that average and just go with like, well, a little less than that average, 60 days. And I feel like I have a habit formed. Like, but anyhow, so like, so I have things on here like floss, go to bed by 11. I've done really bad at that. Like, I never go to bed by 11. So stuff like that. Making the bed, I've gotten really good at. I've never been one to make my bed, but that's a very important thing with the Fly Lady stuff. So I've been doing that. I always hated flossing too. I don't know why. It's such a very immature thing to not want to floss. I mean, you're brushing your teeth anyway. Why not floss as well? But whatever, it's a thing and I've hated it my whole life. So that's something I'm working on and I've been doing pretty good. These 2 days I was actually sick. So it was all I could do just to brush my teeth because I just wanted to go to bed so badly. But anyhow, so now I have some habit trackers in here. So that I'm putting there. So, and then the next section that I'm going to have is my meal plan section. I have just printed these out, so I haven't done anything with them whatsoever. So they're blank, but I'm just putting a few months in at a time. And then as, you know, more months come in, I'll put more stuff in. And then in between each month, what I want to do is put some, like, scratch paper for the month. Just so I can do my grocery list on, and because I'm not going to keep my grocery list forever. So it's just something I want to be able to, like, throw away when I'm done. So I don't want to use my good paper. This is also from an old Happy Planner. One of the bigs I got on clearance from Michaels, like one of the grab bags or whatever last year. So I had a ton of them. And so I had no idea what I was going to do with any of it. I'm having the hardest time as I rip it out. So I just cut it down to like this size, however many boxes, 3 boxes. But like they usually go that way, like this way. But that's too small of an area for me to write. I write really big. So I just turned them to the side and punched them that direction. So I just want to have these in here so that I can make my grocery list with, based on whatever, you know, the meal plans that I create. So that's that. Okay. These aren't going in right. Struggling. Alrighty, so after that section, I've got, going along with meal planning, I created some freezer inventory lists. So I'm going to go through my freezer. I'm a bit of a food hoarder. So I have a chest freezer, an upright freezer, and a refrigerator with a small freezer on top in my garage. I don't know why I hoard food so badly, but I do. So like some people hoard shoes, I hoard food and planner supplies apparently. But anyhow, so that's that section. So I've got, I'll just mark off, I guess, yeah. I'm gonna use the erasable pen on these, so, or pencil, but most likely pen because I like pen better. The like friction pens, which I don't have near me, or I'd show you. But anyhow, so I'll just put a mark as, you know, what we have, and then I'll erase as we use it up. So I've got a section or a column or section or whatever for my AIP meals, which is the autoimmune protocol. So this is stuff that's only for me. And then a section for meals that my family can eat and everything. One for meats, one for veggies, one for fruits, breads and baked goods, baking items, and then miscellaneous. So that will be that. And then the last section that I've got so far is these little Tombow sheets that I got printed off of Tombow's website. It's for hand lettering. I don't like my handwriting at all, and I really want to work on it. And I would love to be able to do like the pretty little hand lettering that, you know, you see on all these videos all the time. But I don't have that skill set. So I just printed some of these off so that I can practice that. It's something I want to work on this year. Because I have handwriting like a 10-year-old boy. So anyhow, I'm going to put these like dividers in so that I can have my sections all. I took them out of plastic already because I find that noise to be pretty horrible on the videos. So to spare you on that. But I am not sparing you the clicking sound of putting things in. But personally, I love that sound. So apologize. Alright, so at the beginning. Alright, so this will kind of start my Fly Lady type section. So yeah, all that will be in there that month. All right, after that is my habit tracker section. And I will label these later. All right, after that is my meal plans. And we have, all right, the, and I have two packs of these things, so I grab another one. All right, so I'll have the freezer inventory. I don't know if I'm going to do a pantry inventory. I might. I just know that I forget about what's, especially in my chest freezer, I forget what's in there because it gets all buried in there. No matter how many times, like every, maybe like twice a year, I try and go through it and like, quote unquote, keep an inventory, and I never follow through with it. So maybe I will if it's all pretty and in my planner. Okay, so this one will be for the hand lettering. Is anybody else obsessed with the sound? I love the sound of these rings or the discs, stuff going in them. Also love the sound of bones cracking too. So maybe that's why. But anyhow, and then I have an extra one, so I'm just gonna stick it in the back because I'm sure something, some other section will pop in my head and I'll want to put it in there. So, oops, that is it. I think I'm done. All right, so that is my setup for my main planner for 2019, which also has my Fly Lady stuff and some other kind of collections in there. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing for more videos like this. I will see. I always struggle at the end of these videos, like what to say. It is super awkward. So sorry about that, but yeah, I will see you next time. Have a good one. Bye. I totally forgot to show you how I'm actually using the main part of my planner. So I showed you all the setup stuff, so I'm sorry, I'm gonna cut this back in somewhere, I'm not sure, maybe at the end, who knows, we'll see. Anyhow, so the way I'm using the layout for the Socialite is, well, on the calendar year at a glance, I'm just highlighted in like a really light purple, which I don't even think you can see. Super blurry, not adjusting. There it goes. Okay, so just in like a super light purple, just the days that my kids have off from school. So that's all I am using this calendar for, the yearly, at a glance on this one. Zoom me back out. Okay, then also what I do is before every month, I have just a monthly to-do list page that I'm putting in front of every section or every month, and then that is what I base my, you know, to-dos for the day. The monthly overview is just appointments, you know, the days my kids are off school. My family are at the river right now. We have no school tomorrow. Any kind of appointments, things like that. So that's what I'm using the monthly for. And then, so, you know, there's a lot of people that have like trouble with this color block layout. I wasn't really sure how I was going to use it. I don't think I'm a vertical planner. I don't know, because last year I used vertical and I didn't like it because I write very big. But I liked the Socialite, so I just went with it. So how I'm using it is I kind of like the color block aspect to it because it kind of minimizes the amount of to-dos that I put in my everyday, you know, sections. Typically, I just have running to-do lists, and I never get any of it done because I don't have the time or energy to do so. But what I'm doing is the top little square area is just for things that are like musts for the day kind of thing, or like if I had New Year's Eve there, UCF versus LSU. That's like, I'm a UCF alum, so that was a huge game for us, even though we lost terribly. It was painful to watch. Anyhow, back to work that day. We had, you know, had to get life insurance quotes that day. So things that had to be done that day, you know, the day. And then the other ones, so the four other ones, I'm using for a to-do list. So I'm only putting like one thing in each box. And then down at the very bottom one is just what we're having for dinner. Since this one obviously doesn't go all the way down, I just put it there. It's moved it up one. And then this one I do kind of, you know, have like a running to-do list errand type thing. So that is how I'm doing that. And then bullet journal-esque, which, you know, obviously not much of this is very bullet journal-y, but I do have carryover stuff. So if I get it done, obviously I put a check mark or a line through it. And then if I didn't get it done and I need to, I just migrate it. So I put a little arrow and then that'll go to the next week. I don't do it for the on a daily basis. So like if I have something that I'm supposed to, you know, that I have on to do Monday and I don't get it done, I don't migrate it over within the same week. I'll just go back and check it off. If I do it later in the week, I still can see it. It's, you know, all at a glance. So I only migrate it over if I'm flipping the page. That way I can see what needs to be done. So if I put an X through it, it's something that I didn't end up having to do. Check marks, obviously done. Kind of got most of the stuff done that week that I wanted to get done. So yeah, that's really just how I'm doing that. So that's this week. Yeah, that's it. So I don't know how I'm going to insert this into the video since it's kind of a second last thought that I had to show you, but, we'll figure it out. And if I don't insert it in, I'll stick it at the end and it'll be another awkward, exit that I do. So anyhow, questions, comments, leave them down below. See you next time. Bye.